Good evening, Mina Ransford, the Lubi Metzger. This is a career you should come to know every day na AYV television. Well, inside the first story, the Methodist Church Salendo appoints Reverend Elijah Tommy Akibo Jones as chairman of the Western District Synod. This, according to Reverend Elijah, and a turning point at the Methodist Church of Salendo, as he talks, he will work with the church in new strategic plan where he will help for improve the church. When he talk this way, he will talk about a plan them where he get for carry on with for move the church go before after the induction service na the Buxton Memorial Methodist Church na Freetown. Well, he been talk more inside this interview. There are 70 preschool teacher them they receive certificated benefits from 1 week training inside the National Union of Private School them will be organized during the weekend. The main reason for the training now for see how they go able to get rank to teach them for see how they go able to teach picking them now nursery but the basic and important thing them when the picking them go understand during them temporarily. The training be owned by the Orthodox Christian College of West Africa. That's how I love inside this story. We get for the Methodist Church Salon as Terminal Point Reverend Elijah Tommy Akibo Jones as chairman of the Western District Synod. Well, according to Reverend Elijah, this is a turning point at the Methodist Church of Salem. As he talks, he will work with the church in new strategic plan where he will help for improve the church. He talks this way, he will talk about implant them for the church after induction service at the Buxton Memorial Methodist Church of Freetown. Well, he will talk more inside this interview with AYV.
This man, like a turning point down our church in life. You know, from time from last year, we don't work on a document. We didn't look at the church first, which we come out over 200 years ago. Then we look at which we do now. Then we say, okay, but also we do. We begin look at which we want from go. Then we begin lay strategy there now. One now, like the evangelism, you know, from where the church that don't build from over 100 years ago, we're not able to open more church, and still, we're not able to strengthen the church like how we've been supposed for them to. So we don't concentrate on evangelism. We want to open more church, we want to increase with membership. That's not one thing we do. And as we do that, we train the people then, we go engage in that process, you know, for bring people in camp, the one way we responsible for bring the people in camp, the one way we go responsible for do counseling and do training, all that kind of thing. But the other thing we go do, now we church property. How will they manage them property them there for let it serve the church well? Because now we're strain for them money. So we get for look at all them property we get, list them, and try to give them market value so that, you know, they will bring you some income, you know, that the church will be able to move the church in before. The other thing where we get for do, we get for, you know, equip people there, train the ministers them more, train the laity them more, so that they go able for deliver, so that any service somebody finishes, be able for deliver. For all the Methodist people them, now for all the strategic planning documents, because then are the documents now where they can carry we go for each. Well, I know I say the promised land, but then that the document is where they can carry we go to another level, to a higher level.
Well, that's the Reverend Elijah Tommy Akibo Jones, one of the new chairman for the Western District Synod at the Methodist Church. Well, after the launch of the National Tree Planting Campaign all about the country, the Director of Forestry and the Minister of Agriculture, Alpha Omar Oli, then joined in with Kalusha Farmer Development Organization over the weekend, then plant over 3,000 different tikkenen in Masau Village, but local districts within the northwest parts of the country. When we talk during the planting exercise, Alpha Lee say if the land people ever planting, then go help the government for reduce the pressure with the forest is already in the country. Let me hear what you say.
Well, today, at least we plant well over 3,000 seedlings of assorted forest reserve. We are in, you get acacia, you get melina, you get Tectonia grandis. So now that we can plant here today. And you go believe say then take care of all day. It's very, very important so that it gets economic value so that this country will be able to go before. Just like as I don't start here in the government of Sierra Leone through the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry, specifically the Forest Division, I think we get for engage the Minister of Agriculture, the professional heads, and the permanent sector tell them exactly, because we, now the technical wing of the division, will advise them why we decide, say, for the established forestry plantations, and we are in the co-manage with the community people. Because we believe, say, if we take the forestry activities to the doorsteps of the people, then that one will help the people, that one will help government, and it will reduce the pressure on the forest reserves that we will get.
And the natural disasters, the way they go on, so we get a tree planting today, and Masimba achieved them, one village of them called Masau. At least we don't do for the past 10 years. We don't do in various locations then, Lokimbi, Magbab, Makuba, Masanke, and so on. If the government come to help for give you support, one, it will create employment for the community, stability for the community, then it will even help them for make them aware within the dangers of deforestation at the community. Challenges they will get, there are many in terms of getting seedling, getting the seeds, tools, transportation, you know, finance for move, because partially all the two they do so is like an individual effort, self-help. You know, now when they come through the ministry for Seattle, they said they will come for collaborate with people, help me.
The Deputy Minister for Trade and Industry, Reverend Abraham Cissé Jones, don't call on people at the Wellington community for put politics aside and focus on development. He talked this way with the commission while letting Jack pump water. Well, we MI Distillery, one company where the operator Wellington do for the people them, and a project with the community relation officer for the MI Distillery say cost about 32 million.
I hear this message, but everybody change in mind. How do you think? Because politics don't know. Whether you like it or not, you don't know. There's no going back. Nobody ever has a compass anymore, bag on paper. Finish. What you need for the now? We for embrace one another. We for shake hands with one another. We for join on with one another. Let me move Sierra Leone. The most important color now, that green, white, and blue.
As a result of the way people have been staying for about 10 years for this country, and more especially this area and the deprived area, one of the challenges is in water facility. You know, school picking, young picking, always at the try for go far, for go get this, that, you know, all anything necessary for say, yes, now the time is the right time, you know, for not come with this good water facility here for them. Now, we don't do several water construction, then we don't do them for communities, then we don't donate a lot of things them to community people then, as part of the corporate social responsibilities then. All this it costs about 32 million somewhere. We expect them to use water judicious things for use them, you know, for the community people then, because whether school picking them, small picking them, you know, just like we're within the new direction with president, with the president, our president Mother Bill, he was Mother Bill, talk up. For say you go to Kila for go school. So do that it said, people not need to go to water far distance. They need for go water from this point at least for us, dress for the school. And we could give them feet for going to water well near to them. Because they may restrain too much of water facility. We afford everything, if even if any damage caused to the water facility, because as a massive pump, 9 feet down under the water, we give them a tap, we are ready to give them for the user, any kind. Two ways the water develop, another way the pump gets. If you can, we renovate and back, we handle back to them back.
Because this community, you know, they ever get fine water well, like, so happy before I start my life. We will keep our way, if you know they make the film, they make any time, we will tell you, water well, we will be in a
The Freetown City Council and Rampal in Patna, when I make it happen, don't start for Bill Classroom, then at the Fataraman Municipal School and the E.B. Williams Municipal School of Freetown. This project will last for 3 months. The Freetown Mayor, Yvonne Akisoya, will go to the turning of the sword that the two school them, and Balu Sheriff gets more.
As we for push the country in free quality education, the Freetown City Council with them partner them when I make it happen, don't start for build classroom them na the E.B. Williams Municipal School and the Fataraman Municipal School. The E.B. Williams Municipal School go get 15 classrooms and the Fataraman Municipal School self go get 8 classrooms. Where E.B. they give his statements, the mayor for Freetown Yvonne Akisoya say the teacher them for make sure say the pikin them for speak English as that go help them na the school. The principal them na then school ya being glad for this new development and then promise say then go use the structure for the right purpose. Boku organization them don they give support for the free quality education so that the pikin them go get quality education na the country. Ali Sherif, AYV News, Freetown.
Young people in Asalina, people them really between the age of 15 to 35, and they account approximately one third of the country population. Today, young people in Asalina, they face plenty challenge. Forget work, now while as teen and gist, they expensive. For sake of this, the Star Watch Foundation, don't stand by for organize one free driving course for about 200 young people in the country. This will give them the sabi for drive and self-reduce accidents. We can happen with a lock in sabi drive and on professionalism. Can cause that. Joseph Johnson, Kona Report.
Salon gets about 60% youth unemployment rate. We make it be one of the highest in West Africa, according to one UNDP report. As the country they fed for boost the economy and create opportunity them for young man them, young auntie and for good strength to young people them. The executive director of Star Watch Foundation, Thomas Christian Weeks, explain what he motivates them.
What make a talk about this idea as young man, as an organization, we believe so this kind of idea it was talk about driving with the help of cellular safety, then we can move forward and join the face of fat driving at this country. Well, we got a very big numbers now, the past 200. When by session and go for take class, a job to nobody will ever difficult. We need to go for get the after everything and go for get the certificate. Say they don't go through this course and don't become successful. Now, but at the end, we will advocate for them. We will have the media and talk on them. We have maybe certain people who come on board and we can recommend them for job. For example, we come on board with me. And we believe, say, with government here support back, the president and others surrounding safety, and we can turn the face about bad driving, as I say.
But how this impact young people then? Some of the beneficiary then be explained. Why did they enroll?
Announcement. I don't just graduate from university, but I see them under the benefits, not get a job. So like where my sister here, this they get for me, and all along I know they aim for better, right? But like I'm not to get the Z. I did do the inquiries, but I not get the Z, but because of the time. So like when I give this one, I say now that I'm not the lunatic, this is like a great opportunity for me and a lesser cost.
Because I want to know how to learn to better here. First thing I will then, if I have a job, I will take it. So you know how to learn to better here. Then if I have a commercial job, I will take it because it's an income.
Actually, I've been only going around for driving because that's what I've been getting passion for. But like something else been taking my mind away from driving. I mean, I'm not realizing, but I don't lay down. I see pricing in the door as I'm going to see now, lay down. So like I don't lose focusing on it. But since I see this advert, I decided to say, make use of the opportunity to carry on with this. So I plan to say at the end of the day, at the end of this program, I'm going to be able to drive again.
The public relations officer for the Sierra Leone Road Safety Authority, Abdulkarim Dumbuya, described the initiative as good one because it complements the work of the authority for reduce accidents and bad driving at the country. The initiative, people and believe say, it will give strength to young people and also reduce the kind of a way people can drive in the country. For AYV Creators, Mina Joseph Johnson, the reports of Freetown.
Blind people in Abuja is concerned over the free quality education package with President Bio just launched. They say the package negative provision for addressing special needs as their own condition different from able people in the country. George Philip Jambawai from Bogona reports.
After the launching of the free quality education package by His Excellency Retired Brigadier Julius Mada Bio, now Freetown, as it been promised the country during the political campaign, the blind teachers them now both district gladly for this development. And same way, don't raise concerns say the free education package where they just launched not get any provision for address their special needs.
This free education package where it's sent, yes, it's good. But you know, send a move to really disable them because as I listen radio, I know you're any side we don't talk about help for disabled, even when we can don't come out in our colleges then. where they come for, let we even get employment from other schools then. We know they're not able to give we. Let them marginalize, we don't know what's happening. But we want to let them know, say, even the everyone there, we competent pass there. What they're able to work for, do pass there. Everyone they even understand, say, we get privilege for we be educated. And we get privilege for no we learn.
The Deputy Director for Book Learning Business, Nabo District, John Amara Sware, being get for talk, say, the free education package there for all men, including the blind teachers, them.
We always they make provision for them. And by nature, the free quality education when they launch is very inclusive. It is for all Sierra Leoneans, including the physically challenged.
George Philip Jambawai, AYV, Bo.
Well, family still watch AYV Creates, when they come to the West Street studio inside Freetown. We first step, people can see, following man, I get nothing for do it on football. No. Well, otherwise, we go left you first, but we come back. Just, I don't come back, and you still know that you say AIV studio in the West Street inside Freetown. Well, I'll tell me to join the studio in McKinney for use in that part of the country.
Thank you from the studio in Freetown. Me in August title 2A, we will bring to on the top to you them in the north. For access information from public official then, now one big challenge with the public, especially journalists them can face. Most time, one in a public office can take and say, now wait for check but them work. Well, for assisting the general public able access information from public institution then, government don't form one commission, renamed the Right to Access Information Commission, where don't begin work from 2014. Alhaji Bakar Kanu, now the PRO of this commission, now the note, and they've been talked to me about their mandate and serve the kind of information then with the public for access.
Access to information commission, government get very few information we have exempted information we public not the access easily. Like information we get a potential for bring chaos and the country, we get security threats. Information really infringe on the rights of an individual, like private information, we get for due with a client and a professional like doctors or lawyers. So then kind of information we get from those secret societies. Those are the kind of exempted information. But even with that, according to the Act, if the public interest for that information outweigh the clause where the information you try to protect, you can make them public. Because the Act make them say information they're not limited to public purview. If first you want information, you know, MD, you get 15 working days for disclose that information and make them public. So if you don't disclose that, the person come to the Access to Information Commission and make a complaint, the commission can step in strongly. As I said in the opening statement, the commission get powers of a high court. And can summon that public authority, levied fines, like in the case of institutions, the commission can fine up to 100 million years. In the case of a private individual, it can fine up to 10 million. Or it can go jail, or even both, as a commission may determine. According to the Act, the Act not limits anybody for access to information, irrespective of your class, your ethnic group, your political party, or any other thing, not the limit, even the age, not the limit for access to information. Okay. As long as you're a citizen, go to a public office. And according to the Act, public authority, in all the as a general definition, public authority according to the Act, and define as any office where they collect monies on behalf of the people of Sierra Leone, they are accountable to the Act. So if a private citizen go request for information, it mandates you upon that public authority for listing information within 15 working days with the Act stipulates.
Now we dey take we next to him. Stone mining are one difficult work where Boko people then can do for survive. Most of the time, women and pikin themselves can involve in this hard work here. For not the concern of one them where they broke stone and masongo inside Bombali district, we report a Mohammed Papa Bangoya bingo waka na the quarry.
This na masongo Makari quarry. This is one of the biggest quarry in the country, outside in the pool stone for make development in the country. But people the way they live in this community, also they use this place for make a living. Now you have plenty young man, woman, and picking themselves, they come for work and get money. Today, we come for talk to them, make them tell we how this work turn like for them, Naya.
So we do this work because of the work done for them. The children get from good school, then send back Nadu with the free do self. Nothing of them. So better students will make, we decide say, look, we do this work. A manual way. Because we don't get machine, we don't make cement factory. Okay, damage now, we get serious damage now, because of we don't get safety. The car will be through the hook, so you see the back there, eh? I make sure. That's the way the hook now, if you let get seats, and ring boots, and add that cap, you know the. So now, because you straight that, the hook will be straight now. Well, while the government face can't come in now, we will serve the girl hook inside the, with the community that will survive small, small.
For this Tony and Adele, they buy all things. For Pikida, they buy boots. We buy pen, shoes. All Pikida, they go to school. They get along.
Me now, a student at the Anaspekoma University of Science and Technology. Me, we suffer a lot. But now from this quarry, we want to see so. Now they are able to get what they use as fees. But really, it's not easy. The work we get in this quarry is very tedious. It's tedious for me, really. We don't get to do them because we will help you for go far. But really, we come up to the need of the government for me to intervene. If not, come in safe, they will count there because we know say, other come in one camp, one camp, and cement, one camp, cement factory. If they able to count them come in there, we will help we as you demand the way around there. But really, it's not easy for we.
Well, when I don't see plenty of women there. A man then self picking them where they involve now this stone mining now this community. But also say if government and self private sector they intervene here for create work for them, then go always happy. Reporting for AYV, me na Mohammed Papa Bangura, na Masungbong Makari, Isai Bombali, Makiri.
Plenty thank you, Papa. You be the watch top toy then our studio inside Makeni. And me na Augusta Ethel Toy. We go now anuna over to the studio na Phaeton.
Plenty thank you to Augusta Toy and with team na Makeni. Well now na tell me for the latest business news. As the local government law day against street trading in the country, Phaeton and other parts of the country don't use for the duties. So the Phaeton City Council will begin relocate street trader them. Well, this, according to the council, could make the central business district area decent more for tourists than investors for them with the currency of the country, and same so will give free movement of motorcar and motor man them. And Balu Shayi be Fenot and Gona report.
As well for address street trading in the country, the Phaeton City Council then put ban on street trading. Now over 10 streets there na Phaeton. Then streets there where the Phaeton City Council don't ban na Gloucester Street, Shaker Stephen Street, Walpole Street, and other one them. The Information, Education and Communication Officer, na FCC Koma Hassan Kamara say the council prepare for relocate then street traders here.
But nobody not for move along, even the one that with the whole market center and they go up and down, they're not for do that. So that kind two type of operation will they do. There's a procedure going on now na council. If you want to be part of that relocation, you get for ensure say you register. Because as I talk to you now, that they demarcate lines them, that they demarcate places them for people, that they register. So if you don't register, you just go up and down, then, I mean, you have yourself to be blamed.
Some of the street traders themselves say they're willing for commoner streets if the council give them market space.
So we pray for like God help, for like council will be able to make a provision for we. Because right now, we don't know how they can go.
You know, God say, we dey dey on our streets forever. But all government fence side for sell for we. Let city council them back up we. The fence side for we for sell stagnant. When they say yeah, can't make a small table. Let you serve your family living.
Issue for letting at least take we from the streets. It's not too bad. But like if there is a let down policy, at least the provision is there. It's good. The markets we don't just construct. You find out that the shops are very small.
Well, right now, you know how the country is right now. The country, it's ganga. And business right now, it's not easy for we because city council, the one thing I got put in our street. You know, say we said no one come on our street, one come on our street. But we sign all day. If not, the other side, we don't fail for we. For no self for do business, or for come out. But we sign all day. Then we say no, get self for go. Pass yourself for the manage. It's got to be the pool, but now we need pool again. So we say, they can't, team up on my end, one, two of you by the way, they see we, so instead they call you around, so one this, one that.
The Freetown City Council say this operation will start soon, and anybody with them fend the streets they sell will face the law. Balu Sharif, AYV Business News, Freetown.
Let's thank you to Balu Sharif for that report. They will now attend for the latest sports news as Muhammad Jawad Mialedin at the studio. Come on, Muhammad.
Hello, Ransford. How are you?
Fine.
Okay, well, we'll start with sport news tonight because Friends of Atuga Mini Stadium organization inter-community competition runs starts at the Atuga Mini Stadium playing field. And the game will be between, the first game will be between Susan's Bay community and Kisi community. After the 90 minutes, the game will end goalless with sports reporter Mohamed Abukonte go now report.
The Friends of Atuga Mini Stadium Sports Organization, the Inter-Community League don't start at the Ibrahim Atuga Mini Stadium playing field. Wusa ibi play between Susan's Bay community and also Kisi community. After the full 90 minutes, the game be end goalless draw. Whilst the head coach for Kisi community, Wena Kekuda Mansare, he said the results to Ram a good. He really wants the 3 points. In that he secure the 1 point, then go home and put the house in order for the next match we will come. And therefore encourage all in fans them for giving support to the team.
The game is playing, no problem. I have a couple of my team, all the boys. I know I have some supporters with my boys, but the team I have is no problem. Well, just better of scoring part of the game. Although we have our chance, but not the utilize of them. But I believe in the next match we are going to make our goals. I God's grace, I hope we are going to win our next match. It's all great.
The head coach for Susan's Bay community is insatisfied with the results.
Good start for me as a coach because I come for truth, I come for win on the field. I get you, that's a good start for the community. That's for football. So I will run from the mistake to go to the UN ball.
For AYV Sports, Mohamed Abukonte, the report inside Freetown.
Now, the Douaza Grassroots Football Association don't start one under eight competition at the Douaza playing field. The opening ceremony will be between Wiyon FC and Junction 1 FC. And Junction 1 may end up for winning the game by 2-0. Mohamed Abukonte will be there now go report.
According to Matahana Konte, winner the organizer for the under 8 competition at Dwazak playing field, he said the purpose of organize this competition now for scout out young players them within the community we will represent the country, now the under 17 and also the national team. Junction 1 FC winner Abubakar Kebi a gladi for waiting team get forget the first win na the group as then they look up to the next match.
We're very happy because now we're part of the team and this we don't work for. We really come at the field determined and we don't really put the boys them together and then do extremely well. I want to tell them thank you and the team managers they're all thank you. I want for me to still believe in me, say Junction 1, now we will win this particular competition. And as we don't start for beat today, that's all we beat so to go, for me themselves will be happy.
While the head coach for Wiyun FC, Wena Kamad Dumbuya, he say he will get the high hope for win the game, but the results go home and put in house in order for the next matches them we then go forget now the group and therefore call on his supporters them for rally behind the team.
Well, the game actually
us to the expectation really every day at the point for win. But I look at say now, the player they really play, but lucky not the winning side, not the fourth season. So I take college as a coach. The word I get from the fans is actually, at the time for motivate all fans of Lyon FC, at the time I say, let them all discourage, let them take out. I believe so the next game, we will definitely win out.
For EYV Sports, Mohamed Aboukonte, the report inside Freetown.
Okay, and Sport, now all that we get for sports here this evening.
Okay, please thank you to Jawad for that report. Well, I also will tap AYV Quiz for today, but if you have comments by use, you can send an email to info@AYVnews.com. Members at 9 o'clock, let's prime time use will come up. May not call you to the lines for the remits that is thank you and ask that you continue for watch AYV TV all time. And send you to members at AYV, that is Salon Sabi.